Why don't we listen to that one again, huh?
Welcome to the Arena Central.
May I take your order, please?
Yeah.
You want whale sperm with that? No! I hate the 60s. I hate school. I hate principals. I hate vice principals.
But my true, pure, refined hatred is reserved
for guidance counselors. Happy Harry just happens to have in his very hands a copy of a memo written by one Mr. David Deaver, guidance counselor extraordinaire, to one Miss Loretta Crestwood, high school principal. I find Cheryl unremorseful about her unfortunate condition. Bastard can't even say she's knocked up.
What channel?
And she's unwilling to minimize its effect on the morale of the student population. Guidance counselors. If they knew anything about career moves, would they have ended up as guidance counselors? What do you say we call Deaver up, huh? Our Harry just happens to have
the home phone numbers of every employee of the Paradise Hills School Commission. Here we go. There you are, Mr. Deevsky.
Deaver residence. David Deaver speaking.
You're live. We're doing a piece on high schools. We understand that you're a guidance counselor.
I'm head of guidance here at Hubert Humphrey High in Paradise Hills, Arizona.
I've been here 7 years.
Could you tell us a bit about what you do?
I run
a comprehensive American values program in which we discuss ethical situations,
sex education.
What do you say to young people who look around at the world and see that it's become, you know, like a sleazy country, you know, a place you just can't trust?
Like your school, for example. How come it wins all of these awards and yet students are dropping out like flies? Why is that? Now,
my listeners are curious about your participation in the decision to expel Cheryl Biggs.
I'm not aware of anything like that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, that's not true, sir.
Cheryl refuses to accept suggestions of a more positive mental attitude towards her health and her future. I'm afraid I find no alternative but to suggest suspension.
Who is this? How did you get this number?
Do you admit it, sir?
Admit what?
That you're a slime.
Now, wait just a minute.
You interview a student.
And then you rat on her. You betray her trust.
Isn't that right, sir?
Well, as you can see,
these guys are played out. Society is mutating so rapidly that anyone over the age of 20 really has no idea. All right, back down to business.
I share a room with my older brother. Nearly every night after he turns off his light, he comes over to my bed and gives me a few arm noogies and stuff. And then he makes me scratch his back and other refinements. Well, it's about time we had some refinements on this show. Then sooner or later he gets worked up and without further ado, he rubs his thing and makes me watch. Signs yourself screwed up.
Well, first of all, you're not screwed up.
You're an unscrewed up reaction to a screwed up situation. You see, feeling screwed up in a screwed up place in a screwed up time does not mean that you're screwed up. If you catch my drift. Now, as you know, dear listeners, if you enclose your number, the reply
is guaranteed.
Hello?
This is Happy Harry Hart on your live. Is this Miss Screwed Up?
Yes.
Well, I have a couple of questions. How big is it, this thing you described? Is it bigger than a baby's arm?
What, you don't remember or you don't want to tell me?
Or maybe you made
this whole thing up, huh? Remember, my dear, I can smell a lie like a fart in a car.